हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, गुड मॉर्निंग। वेलकम टू माय लेक्चर फॉर क्लास 11 साइंस, सब्जेक्ट केमिस्ट्री, चैप्टर नंबर 14, बेसिक प्रिंसिपल्स ऑफ ऑर्गेनिक केमिस्ट्री। इन द प्रीवियस लेक्चर्स वी हैव स्टार्टेड अबाउट IUPAC नॉमेनक्लेचर एंड ऑलरेडी वी हैव स्टडीड अबाउट डिफरेंट फंक्शनल ग्रुप्स। नाउ टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी नेमिंग ऑफ IUPAC नेमिंग ऑफ मोनो फंक्शनल कंपाउंड। Monofunctional compound means compound containing only one functional group are called as monofunctional compounds. And that time, the functional group, the longest chain containing the functional group is identified as parent chain and number so as to give the smallest locant number to the carbon bearing the functional group. So let us start the examples. Now see first, here CH3, CH2, CH2, COH. So we have to give number to these. There are four carbon atoms, 1, 2, 3 and 4. And see, it contains COH as the functional group, which is also called as carboxylic group. So in order to give IUPAC name to carboxylic acids, then we have to remember one name, that is alkanoic acid. Remember this, alkanoic acid. Now here, see how many carbon atoms are present, 1, 2, 3, 4. So its name is butanoic acid. See here, butanoic acid. Because you know that butane contains 4 carbon atoms. Now see the next. CH3, CH2, CN. For this, you must remember the name for this. You remember the name. Alkane nitrile. So here, CH3, CH2, CN. So there are 3 carbon atoms, 1, 2 and 3. So its name is what? Propane. Put E also, nitrile. Now see here, it contains CO group, that means it is what? Ketone. For that purpose, you remember this name, alkanone for ketone. You remember this name. Now count the carbon atoms. See here, CO group is near to this carbon atom. So put here 1, it is 2, it is 3, it is 4, it is 5. That means it contains 5 carbon atoms. And so name is what? Pentane-2-one. Now see here again, it is also 1, 2, 3, 4. So it is, its name is what? Butanone or butane-2-one. Now come to next. Here also. Now NO2 means what? Nitro group. For this, you have to remember the name. Nitro alkane. Nitro alkane. Now come to this compound. This is the first carbon atom, it is the second, it is the third. So it contains 3 carbon atoms. So it is what? Propane. And here at the first position, NO2 group is attached. So you the name is what? 1-nitropropane. Now see this compound, it is what? Ether. Its name can be written as what? Alkoxyalkene. Then see 1, 2, and 3. This is alkoxy, so it is OCHT means what? It is methoxy, and it is attached to second carbon atom. So name is what? 2-methoxypropane. Propane because it contains 3 carbon atoms. Now come to the polyfunctional compound. See, polyfunctional compound means what? The organic compounds possessing two or more functional groups, same or different in their molecules, are called polyfunctional compounds. When there are two or more different functional groups, one of them is selected as principal functional group and others are considered as substituent. In order to give IUPAC nomenclature to polyfunctional compounds, you must know the principal functional group decided on the basis of following order of priority. So you have to concentrate on these groups. First is what? COOH, second SO3H, third COR, fourth COCl, fifth CONH2, CN, CHO, CO, OH, NH2, alkene and alkyne. So you must remember this order in order to give IUPAC name to the polyfunctional compound. Here, first preference is given to COH and last preference is given to what? Alkyne. According to this order. Similarly, CHO get first preference before OH. So like that. Now see, the longest carbon chain containing or bearing single or the principal functional group is identified as parent chain. You know that ether is named as alkoxyalkene. While naming it, the larger alkyl group is chosen as the parent chain. Now numbering of parent chain is done so as to give the lowest possible locate numbers in the carbon atom of this functional group. And the name of the parent hydrocarbon is modified with appropriate suffix in accordance with single principal functional group. Suffix can be written at the end and prefix can be written initially. That you must remember. Name of the other functional groups are attached to this modified name as prefixes. Now come to directly example. See here. Write IUPAC names for the following structures. Now here. CH3, CH, OH, CO, CH2 and CH3. Here the principal functional group is what? Ketone. CO. And OH group is the substituent. OH group is given as, this is the 1, it is 2, 3, 4 and 5. See, here OH is the substituent, therefore its name is what? 2-hydroxypentane. Pentane 3 on, because at third position CO is attached and therefore here CO is the principal functional group and OH is the substituent. Next, now see here, there are two functional groups, one is what? COH and other one is what? NH2. You know that CUH is the first, so CUH is the principal functional group and NH2 is the substituent. How will you name this? Here you have to put what? 1 1 2 3 4. NH2 is a substituent, so its name is what? 3-amino, and there are 4 carbon atoms, so it is butanoic acid. So its name is what? 3-amino butanoic acid. Now come to what? IUPAC nomenclature of substituted benzene. You know benzene. In this, what happens? One of the hydrogen atom is replaced by another atom or group. So you get what? Monosubstituted benzene. Now come to this compound here. Hydrogen atom of benzene is replaced by chlorine. So its name is what? Chlorobenzene. Now here, NO2 is functional group. Here, hydrogen atom is replaced by NO2 group. So name is what? Nitrobenzene. Here it is called as bromobenzene. Here it is known as iodobenzene. Now here see, this group is what? It is tertiary butyl group. So it, and tertiary butyl group is attached to this benzene. So name is what? Tertiary butyl benzene. Now we will see another examples. Methyl group is attached to what? Benzene ring. So it is name, its name is what? Methyl benzene, which is also called as toluene. And toluene is also considered as IUPAC name. Here NH2 group is attached to benzene. Its name is what? Amino benzene. Amino benzene is also called as what? Aniline. Now see, this is hydroxy benzene, which is also called as phenol. And phenol is also considered as IUPAC name. Now see here. Methoxy group is attached to benzene, so it is called as methoxy benzene. Another name is what? Anisole. Then here CHO group is attached to benzene ring, it is also called as benzaldehyde. Here CUH group is attached to benzene ring, it is also called as benzoic acid. Now see here, this point is very important. Make it star. If the alkyl substituent is larger than benzene ring, in the bracket 7 or more carbon atoms, the compound is named as phenyl substituted alkene. Means in such a type of compounds, phenyl group act as what? Substituent. Now see this compound, 1 2 3 4 5 6 7. So here alkyl substituent contains 7 carbon atoms, and at second carbon atom phenyl group is attached. So here phenyl act as what? Substituent. And so its name is what? Its name is what? 2-phenylheptane. Because 7 carbon atoms, and at second position phenyl group is attached. So its name is what? 2-phenylheptane. Similarly, see here. 1 2 3 4 5 6. Here on alkyl substituents contains only 6 carbon atoms. See 1 2 3 4 5 6. In such a type of compounds, phenyl group is not act as substituents. So its name is what? Exyl benzene. Here alkyl group act as what? Substituent. So it is attached to benzene, so it is known as exyl benzene. Now see, again we have to remember this important point. Benzene ring can also be considered as substituent when it is attached to an alkane with a functional group. Now see this example. See, in this structure CH3CH2CH2Cl, here Cl is the functional group, means it contains alkane containing functional group. In such a type of compounds, benzene ring act as what? Substituent. And see here, फर्स्ट कार्बन एटम इज दिस वन, सेकेंड थर्ड एंड टू, थर्ड कार्बन एटम बेंजीन रिंग इज अटैच विच एक्ट एज वॉट सब्सटीट्यूएंट. सो इट्स नेम इज वॉट, वन क्लोरो थ्री मिथा थ्री फिनाइल प्रोपिन, वन क्लोरो थ्री फिनाइल प्रोपिन बिकॉज इट कंटेन्स थ्री कार्बन एटम्स. Now see second, again here alkane containing functional group, that is what CH2OH. Here phenyl group act as what substituent, or benzene ring act as what substituent, and therefore its name is what phenyl methanol, because it contains only one carbon atom. So it is what phenyl methanol, which is also called as benzyl alcohol. Now next, again here benzene ring COCH3. Its name is what? Acetophenol. It is also called as what? 1-phenyl ethanol, because it contains two carbon atoms. Now see this compound. It contains COCH3 as a functional group. CO is a functional group. It contains two carbon atoms and it is what? Ketone. So its name is what? 1-phenyl ethanol. It is also called as acetophenone. And here phenyl group act as what? Substituent. Now come to disubstituted benzene derivative. Disubstituted means what? Two atoms or group of atoms attached to benzene ring. They are called as what? Disubstituted benzene derivative. Derivative means what? Compound. Now come to the examples. Before going to study examples, you must know see here, if there is one group, that is what Cl, so this is 1, this is 2, this is 3, this is 4, 5 and 6. See this position, this 2 and 6 is called as what? Ortho position. It is shown by O. Then 3 and 5, this position is known as what? M, that is meta position. And this position is called as what? P, that is para position. You remember this. Now come to this again. See here, there are two chlorine atoms attached to the benzene ring. So give number 1 and 2 to these groups. So you get what? 1,2-dichlorobenzene. Di means what? 2 chlorine atoms attached to this benzene ring. So its name is what? 1,2-dichlorobenzene. It is also known as, see this position is what? Ortho. Ortho-dichlorobenzene. Similarly here, at 1, 2, 3. It is called as what? So this position is M. M-dichlorobenzene. Similarly here, this position is what? Para. So it is called as what? Para-dichlorobenzene. It is also called as 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 4 dichlorobenzene. Now see, if two substituents are different, then they enter in alphabetical order, like A, B, C, D, etc. Here, I is attached and Br is attached, but B comes before I, so we have to give number 1 to Br, then 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So you get what? 1-bromo-4-iodobenzene. It is also called as, see this position is called as what? Now similarly, here 1-chloro-3-nitrobenzene. 1-chloro-3-nitrobenzene, C come first before nitrogen. So give number 1 to this, then 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. If one of the two groups gives special name to the molecule, then the compound is named as derivative of the special compound. Now see this compound. Here, if you consider only NH2, then you get what? Aniline. So here, this 1 and it is 2. So you get what? 2-chloroaniline. Similarly here, if you consider methyl attached to benzene, then you get what? Toluene. And so it is 1, it is 2, it is 3. So it is named as 3-nitrotoluene. Similarly, this, if you consider OH, then it is what? Phenol. And see, 1, 2, 3, 4. So you get 4-bromophenol. Now next, we are going to study trisubstituted benzene derivative. Trisubstituted means what? Three different groups of atoms attached to benzene ring, then they are called as trisubstituted benzene derivative. Here also, you have to follow alphabetical order. Now see this compound. See, there are 1, 2, 3 bromine atoms attached to the benzene ring. So, we have to give lowest number to the substituents. So, start from this 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So, here 1, 2, 4, tribromobenzene. Similarly here, now chlorine come first before nitrogen. And so, we have to give number 1 to chlorine. Again, care should be taken that give lower number to the substituents. So, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. We get 1 chloro, 2 fluoro, 2, 4 dinitrobenzene. Dinitro means there are 2 nitro groups. Come to this compound, bromine CH2, CH3. Again here. Now here, see here B come first, so you get 4-bromo, 1,2-dimethylbenzene. Now here, nitrogen N, C and M. C come first, so you get what? Here you get 1,2,3,4,5,6. So you get what? 2-chloro, 1-methyl, 4-nitrobenzene. Similarly here, you get same 1,2,3,4,5,6. You get 2-chloro, 4-nitrophenol. I consider OH. Similarly here, I consider NH2. So you get what? Aniline. Now here 2,3,4,5,6 because it is 1. So you get 2,4,6-tribromoaniline. Similarly here, if you consider OCH2, you get what? Anisole. So you get 1,2,3,4,5,6. So you get 2-chloro-4-methyl-anisole. I hope you understood all this nomenclature. Thank you very much. Revise this again and again to get the idea to write IUPAC nomenclature.